Two new arrivals are coming home today. Both need to be cared for before they can make it on their own.
This is your tree, honey.
As they grow up together, she will help the tree survive. In turn, the tree will clean the air she breathes and make her home more peaceful.
How's that, Dad?
Both can make the world a nicer place.
Looks good to me.
Give a tree a home, and it will give you a place to share some special moments. Mark the major events in your life in a way you'll always remember and enjoy. Plant a birthday tree for any occasion.
I'm going to take your picture now. Get ready.
For more information, write Forest Service, 1720 Peachtree Road Northwest, Atlanta, Georgia.
Oh, wake up, Lloyd. There's lots of exciting things to do.
Name two.
We could watch SuperStation FunTime at 7 o'clock in the morning or at 10 minutes to 3 in the afternoon.
What's so fun about that?
Cartoons, Lloyd. Oh. Like Bugs Bunny, you like him, and the Three Stooges. Little Rascals, the crazy FunTime gang, and Encyclopedia Britannica films.
Oh, divine. 2 times a day, you say?
Yes, plant yourself in front of WTBS. Mm.
The Department of Energy provides consumer information on home energy conservation, including the energy conservation performance of appliances. Phone toll-free, 800-424-5168.
Oh, wow! Look at that cloud!
Oh, you can use your imagination. You can make it look like anything you want.
Yeah, mm-hmm. That one over there, that looks like a lion.
Oh, no, Jerry, it looks like a big hamburger.
No. Hey, let's get our head out of the clouds and watch Fun Time.
When man first looked at the skies, he was confronted by an ever-changing atmosphere that defied his understanding. To explain the weather, he did the best he could with what he had. He used his imagination. To the ancient Greeks, weather changed at the whim of the gods. Thunder and lightning were the weapons of Zeus, the most powerful god of all. Rain and snow, good weather and bad, were rewards or punishments sent from the heavens to the mortals below. But as early as the 4th century BC, Aristotle, in his treatise Meteorologica, observed that everything that is warm tends naturally to rise, a principle that we recognize today as fundamental to our understanding of the weather. Other observations form the foundation for weather proverbs. These were man's first attempts to predict the weather, and a surprising number of them have proved to be correct. Red sky at morning, a sailor's warning. When birds fly low, the storm winds blow. The weather knowledge of the ancients, a curious blend of fact and fantasy, prevailed until the 17th century. Then, with the invention of the thermometer by Galileo and the introduction of the barometer by Torricelli, the properties of the atmosphere became measurable quantities. And meteorology, the study of the atmosphere, became a science. Not every investigator brought the necessary qualities of logic and reason to the task. Some experiments were long on imagination and short on intelligence. But with the progress in the physical sciences that characterized the 17th and 18th centuries, man's understanding of the atmosphere and weather increased steadily. The mid-1800s brought the introduction of the telegraph. And the 1900s witnessed the development of radio communications. These advances made possible a network of weather stations, each reporting to others on atmospheric conditions in the area. Worldwide weather watching became a reality. Meteorological information could now be charted on maps, and for the first time, scientists were able to visualize the global patterns of atmospheric circulation. Then, with World War II, there began a wave of technological developments that have made modern meteorology one of the most complex and far-reaching of all the physical sciences. Today, meteorologists are becoming increasingly accurate in answering a question that has challenged man for centuries. What will the weather be like tomorrow? The study of weather and weather forecasting is one subject that almost everyone is interested in.
The weatherman said it was supposed to be nice today. I sure hope he's right.
50% chance of rain today. Does that mean I wear 50% of my raincoat?
Most of us are concerned about the weather because it affects our individual convenience and comfort. But weather forecasting is important in ways that influence more than our plans for work or play. With accurate weather predictions, a ship's captain can prepare for violent storms at sea. The orange grower can take steps to protect his crop against damaging frost. The rancher can protect his valuable livestock by providing food during a blizzard. Communities can plan to mobilize snow removal equipment to keep traffic flowing. Airline pilots use special weather forecasts to avoid upper air turbulence and plan their flights along the safest and most comfortable routes.
Tomorrow, at the same time, for part two of this film. We'll return with more SuperStation FunTime after these messages.
Get started on a rewarding career in electronics for a free book packed with the facts you need to know. Call DeVry at 892-8484. That's 892-8484.
Now, the Roadmaster professional tire pump that you've seen advertised for $14.95 is yours for just $9.88 during this special limited-time television offer. Yes, this is the same incredible pump that gives 100 pounds of pressure with effortless toe-tapping ease, that pumps flat tires full in seconds, that keeps you from being stranded and saves you the hassle of searching for an open gas station. The only difference is that now it's just $9.88. Pump exactly the pressure you need. The built-in gauge with its easy-to-read magnifier lens tells you when you're done. So lightweight, so portable, it's amazing that it has the power to do so much, so fast, so easily. At this fantastic low price, you'll probably want one for home and one for the car. Here's how to order.
To order, phone toll-free 1-800-257-1234. In Hawaii, call 536-6677. Or to avoid COD charges, send 988 in check or money order to Roadmaster, P.O. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia, 30357.
The funnies are on the Superstation. Carol Burnett.
Stick a steak in a shtick.
Bob Newhart.
I'm a train killer.
Isn't that nice?
All all in the family.
It's all up here.
Ah, cut it out. I ain't got nothing up here. It's all down here.
Sanford and Son.
What have I done? Where have I been?
You've been to Disneyland.
Tonight at 6 on WTBS. You laugh yourself silly.
Ah, don't mind me. I'm just out here flying my kite. You know, these clouds are really magnificent. They just seem to, like, just billow across the sky and sort of keep changing and easing into something different. A good way to watch clouds is to go fly a kite. Yeah, man, I'm advising you, go fly a kite. You see, that way you can just lay back and tend to your kite and look at the clouds and think. And we can all use some time for ourselves to think, right?
Disarrange me. I'll kiss you later. Now, Aldo, darling, listen to Mother. Today I'm entertaining the Maids of Olympia Society, of which I hope to be made president. And my election depends entirely upon the success of today's gathering. And I'm depending upon you, at the conclusion of this meeting, to enthrall them with a violin selection. Now run along to the solarium and do your practicing until Mother calls you.
Yes, Mater. Pianissimo needs more staccato.
Thank you.
shake the bottle. Hey, kid. Beat me over in the back of the house. I'll fix it.
Okay.
Over here, gang. Here, put this around Pete's abdomen. Around his what? I mean around his tummy. That's better. Uppy, uppy, uppy.
Come on, come on, come on.
When a skywriter writes a seven-letter word, it can stretch for 6 miles, and it can be seen from 50 miles away.
Hey, Ron, what does that say right up there?
It says, SuperStation FunTime will be back after these messages.
That's what it says. It's kind of blowing away.
I know, yeah, but I can still...
Mr.
Ball,
nice move Tiggum.
Smack, smack, sugar smacks. Give me a smack, and I'll smack you back. Fun to eat those smacks that we Kellogg's Sugar Smacks.
Kellogg's Sugar Smacks, a part of this complete breakfast.
Now, what is that?
Jump shot.
Give me a smack, and I'll smack you back. Kellogg's Sugar Smacks.
You'll dig them.
Good peanut butter. Good chocolate.
Real milk chocolate, delicious peanut butter.
Delicious.
Reese's. And Reese's butter crunchy cups. With the crunchy, nutty taste of chopped peanuts.
What are you getting? Two milk trout.
Gee, can't go in this way. Has it got a work of it in soap? Sure, in the basement. Come on, fellas, come on. Well, Frankie, can we come? There's gonna be no place for Dave. Now scram.
Thank you.
Super City, brother.
I'll come up and see you sometime.
Try and say this real fast.
Okay.
She sells seashells by the seashore.
All right, let me try it.
I'll get it. She sells seashells by the seashore.
We'll be right back.
She sells seashells.
She sells seashells by the seashore.
Our old angel belongs to someone else.
Lakeshore Music proudly presents the best of Mel Street. 20 classics by one of the greatest country performers of all time. Just listen to what you get.
Oh, by the way, I met a friend of yours today. Darling, this ain't just another love's affair. 'Cause this time I've hurt her more than she loves me. But you make me feel more like a man.
Mel Street left us all with a legacy of musical treasures, and his very best is captured in this very special collector's album. This two-record collection is not sold in any store. Here's more.
Smoky Mountain memories, orphan angel, I know I must let you go. Big diamonds, big blue diamonds on her finger. Even if I have to steal your love, I want you. I'm loving on back streets.
The best of Mel Street is a must for each and every one of his loyal fans. 20 classics are now specially priced on two stereo records, 8-track or cassette for only $7.97. Don't wait. Order today.
To order your collection of Mel Street's hits, call toll-free 1-800-257-1234. In New Jersey, call 800-232-6966. Or to avoid COD charges, send $7.97 for the two-record set, 8-track tape, or cassette to Mel Street, P.O. Box 7500, Atlanta, Georgia 30357.
Remember the day you brought your new daughter home from the hospital? Seems like just yesterday. And remember when she was learning to ride her two-wheeler? How you helped ease the pain? And that day she just didn't want to go to school, how you told her you understood? How you let her know you shared how she felt, and you ended up taking her yourself? You know something, Dad? You're doing just fine.
Here we go again.
Would you like to know how to make your very own cloud? It's easy. First, have your mother put about an inch of very hot water into a wide mouth jar, like this. And then you put it in a dark room or a big closet. We don't have one, let's pretend, okay? Now, place a metal tray of ice cubes over the top of the jar. Now, if you shine a flashlight toward the middle of the jar, you'll see a small cloud. When the warm air rises from the water and it meets the colder air from the cubes, clouds are formed. That's how the Earth makes clouds, and that's how you can make clouds too.
Big puffy cloud right there.
Ooh.
I know they got different names for different kind of clouds, but what do you call that particular kind of cloud?
Ron, that is a cumulus.
Cumulus?
No, Jerry, that's a cirrus cloud.
A cirrus cloud?
Uh-huh.
Are you cirrus?
Say goodbye, Ron.
Say goodbye, Ron.
Goodbye, Ron.
Bye.
Goodbye.
good buddy. I'm here to pick up a load of pits. Last CB talked for fruit.
Seen any?
My trucking friend, if fruit flavors you seek, shift into first and follow my beak. Follow my nose.
Roger, Dodger.
It's always nose.
Breaker, breaker, I smell orange, lemon, and cherry flavors.
Kellogg's Fruit Loop Cereal. Orange, lemon, cherry, and other natural flavors. Fortified to be part of this nutritious breakfast.
These Fruit Loops are threes and eights.
Does that mean they're good?
You betcha, good buddy. Here's the Big Ten Four.
Here it comes. Football, your number one sport. Get every weekend of it with America's National Sports Weekly, Sports Illustrated. We'll get you ready for the season with our two big football previews, college and pro. First, the pros. Sports Illustrated will take the league apart, team by team, from Tampa Bay to Washington to Anaheim, and show you how they stack up. We'll take the teams apart and show you how they line up after the trades and drafts. Then you'll preview the colleges, the juniors who look senior and the seniors who look pro. You'll go from Big Ten to Pac-10 and see how our top 20 compares with yours. Then you'll follow football every week, as only Sports Illustrated can give it to you. Every bomb, kick, blitz, and sack. The gambles that paid off and the strategies that didn't. Full color replays of who did what the week before and why. And what to look for in the games coming up in the week ahead. You'll get all the action and more. You'll see players out of character, owners out of place, and coaches out of patience. A whole season of fun and games, right down through the playoffs to the biggest game of all. Sports Illustrated is the football watcher's armchair guide, and it doesn't stop there. You'll get baseball, basketball, hockey, tennis, golf.
You won't miss a week of any sport with Sports Illustrated. And here's our 1980 football offer. 26 issues of Sports Illustrated delivered to your home for our low basic rate of $17.77. That's only 69 cents an issue, less than half the cover price. All you have to do is pick up the phone and call 800-621-8200. If you do it now, you'll be sure to get our big college preview and our special pro football preview. If you like football, get on the receiving end of a whole season's worth week after week. The phone call is free, so dial 800-621-8200 and start your football season right now.
The Braves will take on the San Francisco Giants tonight at 10:30 and tomorrow afternoon at 4 here on the SuperStation WTBS.
From the far reaches of outer space comes a threat to planet Earth. Mankind faces its most powerful enemy, the mastermind Rodak. The Space Giants. Goldar, a 50-foot robot, and his electronic space family are created to defend our world.
Biking's great fun, but it can be risky, too. Every year, cycling causes 40,000 injuries and 1,000 deaths. If you're a cyclist, keep your bike in top condition and fully equipped for safety at night. Two's okay on a bike built for two, but dangerous on a bicycle for one. Most serious and fatal accidents occur on the street and involve an auto. When possible, avoid heavy traffic. Ride in single file. Use hand signals for turns and change of lane, and always obey traffic laws. At busy intersections, you're safer walking your bike across. Be alert for the unexpected. Remember, they may not see you. 41,000 cyclists are injured or killed each year. Take care, and don't become number 41,001. Good counsel from the American College of Surgeons and this station.
Hershey is real milk chocolate. I love that Hershey bar.
Hershey is
something special, no matter where you are.
Anytime you want delicious chocolate, there's no need to go looking very far.
Hershey's great!
Cause Hershey is the great American chocolate bar.
Tonight's a great night for watching the Superstation, WTBS Channel 17 from Atlanta, Georgia.
Dr. Maz escapes after it is learned that he is treating human beings who have caught a strange illness, converting them into Lugomen. These Lugomen are from the planet Lugo in the Nastrix galaxy and servants of Rodak, an evil man who is out to possess the world. Hovering over the Earth in his spaceship, Rodak sends to Earth Renotis, a monster that creates a strange illness in Earthlings by transforming their red blood cells to blue. Itomura, a reporter for the National Press International, and staff photographer Liz are covering the story. Mura's son Miko tries to stop them.
Hey, let me out. I'll call for help.
Using the whistle given to Miko by Goldar, the Space Avenger, Miko blows once, signaling Gam, Goldar's son. From the fiery heart of Mount Olympian comes Gam, the robot rocket boy.
Ah! Take me to Papa right now. Please, let's hurry.
Okay. Get in, Miko.
Right.
How can I find your father?
Just look out for Papa's car down there.
Is that the one?
That's the car. A monster. That's the creature that's spreading all the disease down there.
Your father's heading straight for the monster.
Pa will be hurt.
What are you doing here?
Papa, over there, look.
Oh.
His blue ray is dangerous.
Hurry. If we don't get out of this area soon, the creature will see us.
What's wrong with my monster, Renotis? All he's doing is smashing things.
But that's good. By smashing things, Renotis is punishing the Earthlings for not surrendering the Earth to you.
However, the monster is supposed to do more than just smash things. Renotis must spread that disease. Lugo number 6, I want you to tell these men how Renotis inflicts the disease. I want everyone.